Today's session is class 7. Topic is some functions and their graphs. Page number F9. So here graphs are two types: transcendental functions and algebraic functions. So first one, transcendental functions. Either one. First one is constant function. Constant function represent as f of x is equals to k. Here k is any fixed real number. For all x belongs to R. Here in the place of x, any real number will substitute, will get the value k, constant number. For example, f of 1 value is k, f of 2 value is k, f of 3 value is k. And one more example, f of 1 x is equals to 3 taken means f of 0 is equals to 3, that means 0 comma 3 point. F of 1 is equals to 3, 1 comma 3. F of 2 is equals to 3, 2 comma 3. And f of minus 1 is equals to 3, minus 1 comma 3. F of minus 2 is equals to 3, then minus 2 comma 3 point. Now we will represent these points in a graph. Now for constant function, domain is R, rational numbers. We are taking here rational numbers. Range of the constant function is constant value. Here in this example, constant value is 3. So now we'll represent these points 0, 3 in y-axis. On y-axis we'll represent the range of the function. On x-axis we'll represent the domain of the function. So 0, 3 and 1, 3, 2, 3, minus 1, 3, minus 2, 3. So now we will join these points. Then it is a straight line and it is parallel to x-axis. So this is the constant function. Next function is identity function. Identity function represent as f of x is equals to x for all x belongs to R. Now in the place of x, any real number will substitute, then we get that number only. Example, f of 1 is equals to 1, f of 2 is equals to 2, f of 3 is equals to 3, f of 0 is equals to 0, f of minus 1 is equals to minus 1, f of minus 2 is equals to minus 2. Now for this one points are 1 comma 1, 2 comma 2, 3 comma 3, 0 comma 0, minus 1 comma minus 1, minus 2 comma minus 2. Now for this one, domain, identity function, domain is R. We are substituting here rational number, real numbers, that's right. R. Range of the identity function is also R. So now graph of the identity function. On y-axis will represent range. On x-axis will represent domain. So here 0 and 1, 2, 3. Here points 1, 2, 3, 4. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. The first one is 1 comma 1 means here, 2 comma 2 means here, 3 comma 3 means here, 0 comma 0, this one, and minus 1 comma 1, minus 2 comma 2. When we join these points, then we will get a straight line and it passes through the origin. It is the identity function. Next, modulus function. It is also called absolute value function. modulus function represent as f of x is equal to modulus x, modulus of x that is equal x where x is greater than or equal to 0 minus x where x is less than 0. So here x is belongs to R, rational number. Whenever you substitute in the place of x, for example, f of x is f of 1 is equal to modulus of 1, that value is 1. F of 2 is equal to modulus of 2 is equal to 2. F of 0, then modulus of 0 is equal to 2, is 0. And f of minus 1, that is equal to modulus of minus 1 is equal to that value also 1. And in the modulus negative values is there, means it will write as positive only. F of minus 2 is equal to minus 2, modulus of minus 2, that value is 2. Now domain of modulus of function is, domain of modulus function is R, real numbers. Range of modulus function is always positive real numbers, is also read as including 0 excluding infinity. So now we'll see graph of the modulus function. Y-axis and x-axis. On y-axis range and here domain. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, and so on. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Now here points are 1 comma 1, 2 comma 2, 0 comma 0, and minus 1 comma 1, minus 2 comma 2. So first 1 comma 1 point will come here, 2 comma 2, and 0 comma 0, minus 1 comma 1, minus 2 comma 2. So when we join these points, we will get like this. So it is the graph of modulus function. Next one is greatest integer function. It is also called floor function or step function or integral function. F of x is equal to integral part of x. That means integral part of x or greatest integer less than or equal to x. That is f of x is equal to n, where n is less than or equal to x, less than n plus 1. N is belongs to I. For example, f of x is equal to 2, then where 2 is less than or equal to x is less than 2 plus 1. That means 2 less than or equal to x less than 2 plus 1 means 3. So here, which the x value is between 2 and 3, then we will get answer is 2 only. For example, f of 5.6, for this value, for this one, answer is 5. 5.6 will write as 5 plus 0.6. Here smallest value is 5. Now we'll represent this on the graph y and x axis. Here range, domain. So for this greatest integer function, domain is R. Range is I. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1.99, 2.99, 3.99, 4.99, here 0.99, -1, -2, -3, -1.99, -2.99, here -1, -2, -3, 1, 2, 3. Here 0 taken means minimum value, less than value is 0, then 0 to 0.99. And next one is 1 to 1.99. And next one 2 to 2.99. So here -1 taken means 0.99. And -1 to -1.99. That means smallest value is 2, -2. So this is graph for greatest integer function. And next one is smallest integer function, is also called ceiling function. It is represented as f of x is equal to x. So x, it is denoted by smallest integer greater than or equal to x. Smallest integer greater than or equal to x. Then here that is f of x is equal to n plus 1, where n is less than x is less than or equal to n plus 1. N is belongs to I. Here also we will take in the place of x 2, then the value, the answer is 3, where 2 is less than x is less than or equal to, sorry, here x less than or equal to 2 plus 1, then 2 is less than x is less than or equal to 3. So greater value you have to take here. So f of 3.6, that value is 4. F of 7.9, that value is 8. Greater value we want to take here. So domain of smallest integer function is, or range of smallest integer function is I. Now we will represent this on the graph. Y, on y axis range we will represent, x on x axis domain. So here also 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, -1, -2, -3, sorry, 1, 2, 3 positive numbers. And here -1, -2, -3, -4, -1, -2, -3, -4. Here greatest value. So 0 to 1 and 1 to 2, 2 to 3, and here -1, 0 to -1, and -1 to 0, sorry, 1 to 2, -1 to -2, -2 to -3. This is the graph of smallest integer function. Thanks for watching the video.